For today's video, we'll be taking a look at a motherboard from Gigabyte that sports the new entry-level AMD B840 chipset and is targeted at folks who are looking to build a budget-friendly gaming PC in the micro ATX form factor, the Gigabyte B840M AORUS ELITE WIFI6E. Sporting support for the latest Ryzen 9000 series of processors, as well as the Ryzen 8000 series of APUs and the older Ryzen 7000 series of CPUs, we'll be taking a closer look at the specs of this board to see if it's any good. Let's get started. To recap, AMD launched its Zen 5 Ryzen 9000 series of processors back in August 2024, and the high-end X870E and X870 chipsets for the AM5 platform back in end September 2024. Fast forward to January 2025, we now finally have AMD's mid-range and entry-level 800 series chipsets arriving on the scene, in the form of the B850 and the B840. As can be seen, the B840 doesn't support processor overclocking, similar to the A620 that it replaces, though it does still support memory overclocking. To get in on the launch excitement, we'll be taking a look at the Gigabyte B840M AORUS ELITE WIFI6E that, as its name implies, sports the B840 chipset and sits within the AORUS series of gaming-oriented motherboard offerings at the higher end, making it a motherboard that is firmly in the budget-friendly side of things and yet still packs some nice features for good measure. As can be seen, the B840M AORUS ELITE WIFI6E comes in a box that has an AORUS eagle motif emblazoned on the front. Moving over to the rear of the box, we get the usual summary of specs for this board. We'll take a closer look at these specs later on in this video. On a side note, if you're new to the ALKtech channel, do consider subscribing so as to keep up to date with the latest product releases in the PC hardware world. With that, let's have a look at the contents of the box. First up, we get a Wi-Fi antenna that comes with the new Wi-Fi Easy Plug connector. Let's set aside the board for now to see what other accessories Gigabyte has included with it. First up, we get two SATA 3 cables, and these are accompanied by a G connector that simplifies the process of hooking up your PC's front panel connectors to the motherboard. Pretty nifty. We do also get two packs of M.2 drive rubber pads that are used to add additional height clearance, as well as a metal AORUS case badge right here. In terms of documentation, we get a multilingual installation guide, as well as a regulatory information leaflet. Onto the board itself, we see that Gigabyte has gone for a black and grey aesthetic with a black coloured PCB and black heatsinks that sport splashes of grey. As can be seen, the board comes with an integrated I/O shield design, and over on the rear of the board, we see that Gigabyte has included some AORUS motifs for added visual interest. A nice touch, I must say, in spite of the fact that most of these motifs would likely never see the light of day inside of a PC case. Fans of integrated aesthetic LEDs for their motherboards will be pleased to note that Gigabyte has included RGB LEDs beneath the chipset heatsink, which do add a touch of pop to the overall appearance of the motherboard. The VRM heatsinks for this board are pretty decently sized, and Gigabyte has included 10+2+2 power stages with 60A DR MOS power phases. The B840 chipset has a single chip design, and the SID chip sits beneath this passive heatsink right here. For M.2 drive cooling, Gigabyte has got you covered with a single large heatsink that provides coverage for the two M.2 drive slots that this board comes with. For memory support, the B840M AORUS ELITE WIFI6E comes with 4 DDR5 slots that, as of the time of publishing this video, comes with support for up to 256GB of RAM and the DDR5 8200 standard when overclocked, with plastic slots that sport a single tab design. Naturally, the board also supports AMD's Expo technology, which are basically built-in overclocking profiles for DDR5 memory. In terms of front panel USB connectivity, we get a USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-C front panel header right next to the RAM slots and near the SATA ports along the long edge of the board, a single USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A front panel header that provides support for up to two USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports. Moving over to the bottom edge of the board, we get two USB 2.0 front panel headers, with each header providing support for two USB 2.0 Type-A ports, for a total of four ports. Some interesting features to highlight: back at the top of the motherboard, we get a reset button, also termed a multi-key button by Gigabyte, that can be reprogrammed from within the BIOS to serve other purposes, a set of status LEDs that can help with troubleshooting PC startup issues, as well as a reset header that can be hooked up to the reset button of your PC case. Moving to the bottom edge of the board, we get a TPM header for an optional discrete Gigabyte TPM module, as well as a clear CMOS header. In terms of expansion slots, this board comes with a PCIe 4.0 X16 slot for a graphics card. The said slot sports Gigabyte's PCIe UD slot design that reinforces the slot for use with heavy graphics cards. As can be seen, the slot also comes with the PCIe Easy Latch Plus feature that helps make removing a graphics card from the slot less of a painful affair. That said, we do also get a full-length PCIe 3.0 X16 slot that operates at X4 mode. In the storage department, Gigabyte has included four SATA 3 ports, with all ports in a right-angled configuration. For M.2 slots, it comes with two PCIe 4.0 X4 M.2 slots. Do note that both of these slots support NVMe SSDs only. M.2 SATA drives will not work in any of these slots. It's worth noting that the M.2 heatsink features a toolless design called M.2 Easy Latch Click, which makes removing and installing the heatsink really easy. Another quality of life feature that the M.2 slots have is M.2 Easy Latch Plus, which makes installing and removing a M.2 drive a toolless affair. For audio, Gigabyte has included an entry-level Realtek ALC897 audio codec. Wired internet connectivity is courtesy of a Realtek RTL8125D chip that provides support for 2.5 gigabit Ethernet, while Wi-Fi support is courtesy of a Realtek RTL8852CE Wi-Fi 6E part that also serves up Bluetooth 5.3 support. In the cooling and RGB departments, the board comes with plenty of fan headers for a micro ATX board, six of them to be precise, which are located in these regions of the board. Also included are three Gen 2 addressable RGB headers and a single 12-volt RGB header located in these regions. Moving over to the rear I/O, the B840M AORUS ELITE WIFI6E goes for an integrated I/O shield design, where the said I/O shield also comes with ventilation openings in the form of parallelogram shapes. The board comes with a DisplayPort 1.4 port that supports a maximum resolution of up to 3840 by 2160 at 144Hz, a HDMI 2.1 port that supports a maximum output resolution of 4096 by 2160 at 60Hz, four USB 2.0 Type-A ports, a PS2 mouse and keyboard combo port, a Qflash Plus button that allows end users to update the board's BIOS without needing to install a CPU, RAM or graphics card, a USB 3.0 3.2 Gen 2 Type-A port, a USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-C port, a 2.5 gigabit Ethernet port, two USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports, Wi-Fi antenna connectors with the new Wi-Fi Easy Plug design, and your usual audio jack connectors. And with that, the Gigabyte B840M AORUS ELITE WIFI6E is an interesting product in that it sports an entry-level chipset but comes with premium features that are typically found on mainstream and premium motherboard offerings, such as a relatively decent VRM setup that should allow this board to handle even AMD's higher-end Ryzen 9000 processor offerings with ease, 2.5Gb Ethernet with built-in Wi-Fi 6E, a decent assortment of USB Type-C and Type-A connectivity options, along with a bunch of nice quality of life features such as PCIe Easy Latch Plus, and so on. At this product segment and price point, you do lose out on Gen 5 support for a graphics card and M.2 drive, which is something to bear in mind, especially if having support for the next generation of PCIe 5.0 graphics cards and NVMe SSDs is high on your list of considerations. With that, thanks so much for watching, hit the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.